Hey guys, what's going on? It's me, Tim, back with a different type of video for you today. So today I wanted to talk about the creative life and mental health, mixing with a little bit of social media. And I want to tell a little bit of a story. Last week I created a video that I was really proud of. I thought it was good. Initially, some people left some really positive comments about the video I made. And then all of a sudden, a couple of days later, I get a really negative comment on a video. And I know that it shouldn't really matter what people say on the internet, or that... you know, that I'm going to get these type of comments once you put yourself out there on YouTube or Instagram or Facebook, that not everyone's going to like what you're attempting to do or what you hope to do. But this comment that was left just really put me in a kind of a bad headspace for a couple of days. Like I'm completely honest with you, was living rent free in my head for about 4 or 5 days. So I actually haven't shared videos like I had hoped to share with you. And I don't really know 100% sure what I'm doing here on YouTube. I'm sharing videos and sharing things that I feel are important, and sharing things that are just like on my heart. So they're not really... anything major, but I wanted to take just a moment out of my time and talk to you a little bit about the negative effects of social media, and sometimes how these things can really inhibit our creativity as creatives. I've been working in the creative field for well over 20 years now. Like I used to teach university, and then I worked at DreamWorks Studios as an assistant film editor, and I had all of these things that I had just fallen in love with doing. And I was let go in 2008 from DreamWorks when the economic downturn happened the last time, and I thought that that job was going to be my dream job. I thought I was going to do the very much the American dream. I was going to work there for 20 years. I was going to get old, and I was going to retire, and just it was just one of those jobs. And when I lost that job, I really went into a bit of like a depression mode. Like I kind of I wasn't creating. I kind of lost my will to really even be a creative, because I was let go of a job that I loved, a job that I had dreamed of, a job that I had thought that was going to be my forever job. It was a major part of my identity as a person, as a creative. If you were to have met me in 2007, 2006, 2008, I would have, one of the first few things would have come out of my mouth is that I worked at DreamWorks Studios and that I loved the job that I was doing. And when I didn't have that, when I didn't have that thing to kind of fall back on, what ended up happening was I went into depression of trying to figure out what I was going to do next. I had my dream job, and my dream job no longer wanted me. And it wasn't that I had done something wrong. It was just what had happened at that particular time with the economy in the United States. So I picked up a camera in 2009 and shot my first wedding. And from that first wedding grew a very budding photography business that I have had the privilege of doing for the last 13 years. And over the last year and a half, 2 years, I've gotten on YouTube and I've just kind of shared my thoughts about cameras and have just shared my thoughts about different cameras that I've shot with over the years. I'm a big Leica fan and film cameras. And I just had all of these things that I wanted to share with you, because I just felt maybe I could do it differently. Maybe that I could re-present to you things that you have seen in just a different way. And I know deep down inside that what I share isn't going to be for everyone. I know that. I know as a minority creator that my voice might not be meant for some other people, and that's okay too. I've come to terms with a lot of things in my life as a creative of knowing that I'm not going to be everything for everyone. But still, this comment that was left on my channel just really kind of struck a nerve in me and kind of really just put me in a mode and of not wanting to create. And I know that there are other people out there that are just like me, that are struggling to kind of find a footing in this creative industry, struggling to try to find a footing on YouTube, or trying to find a following, period. Not even that we create to find a following, but we create because we feel the need to create. And when you put yourself out in the open, you're going to open yourself up to critics. And I know that already. I know that. And I know you know that. Those of you who are watching this, and those of you who may be struggling with some of the same things that I'm struggling with today. But I wanted to share today about mental health issues for creatives. And when you find yourself in a situation that I found myself in last week, where I didn't want to create, that I didn't want to go out and share the videos because of fear of the unknown, the fear that someone may have left a negative comment or may leave a negative comment. And I actually sent out a tweet about this on Twitter, and a friend, someone who I admire, really kind of put things into perspective for me. And it was a woman, and she's like, wow, I wish that I could be a year into creating something and hearing my first negative comment for the first time. And it kind of reminded me of something that someone said to me a long time ago, or not even a long time ago, just a couple of years ago, is that you don't have to travel far to find someone that has it worse than you or better than you. Oftentimes, all you have to do is look up from your phone and you can see all around you that people that have it worse than you. And that has kind of helped me over the years kind of just get out of the funk that I've been in, as I know that I'm very blessed and that that I have a lot of things going that other people don't have going. And I don't take that for granted. I don't take any of that for granted. But if you are struggling from feeling inadequate, if you are having sleeping problems, or if you have negative emotions about the things that you are creating, I wanted to kind of tell you that these are some of the warning signs of declining mental health. And I know this isn't something that we talk about a lot in the creative field. It is just now starting to find some footing. But I know that I struggle from it from time to time, and I'm not afraid to share it with you that I'm kind of going through this. And I hope that maybe making this video, maybe sharing this with you, that doing what we do for a living is not always rainbows and butterflies, but more often it's compromise that moves us along. There's actually a Maroon 5 lyric, and I don't even know why I shared that, but it's so true in life. But when you are suffering from poor mental health with your daily life, you may or may not be struggling through some mental disorders. And I want you to do a couple of things. I want you to reach out to a psychologist or a therapist or to a close group of friends and kind of share what you're going through. If you're experiencing like suicidal thoughts or psychosis or alternating bouts of depression and mania, if you're just kind of going through a situation, then I want to encourage you to reach out and seek help. The creative life isn't for the faint of hearts. And we know this already. We know this, that when you put yourself out there, when you put your work out there, that people are going to say negative things about it. And people are going to be not nice online when we share things that we love and that we do. But I just want to say, if you are struggling with these things, then to seek help, to talk to a friend, to be real honest with your spouse or loved one or your parent, just share with them that you're struggling through some of these things, because then at least someone else can look into you and share what maybe your next steps should be. And I cannot implore with you enough that if you are having suicidal thoughts and you're struggling through things, to please, please seek professional help in some way, shape, or the other. Because I can tell you this, is that we care about you. I'm thankful to have a group of friends who really build me up when I'm feeling down. But sometimes I deal with things on my own, and I know that I shouldn't, and I know that I need to work through things. And it's not always easy to share that you're struggling with your mental health. But definitely, I just want to take just a moment to create something different and to encourage you to seek help, to talk about it out loud when you're struggling with something. Because, you know, truth of the matter is, we are all struggling through something. Maybe it's the lack of jobs, the lack of putting in the work and not seeing the results that you want right away. There are all sorts of things that we struggle through as creatives. But I just want to encourage you to find some help. It's important. You know it's important. I know it's important. And to just share with people. And maybe you don't want to share on social media that you're going through something. Maybe you don't want to create a video like I'm creating today. Maybe you don't want to share on YouTube that someone left a negative comment and it's really putting you into a downward spiral and you're struggling through some things. But I just want to encourage you that people around you love you. I want to encourage you that the work that you're doing is not in vain. And I want to encourage you to just seek some professional help. Mental health is health, guys. We all know this. I'm so thankful that you've given me this platform to share with you about mental health and seeking some encouragement. And I don't know if this is going to help anyone, but I just feel that it's important that we talk about it, and that we share when we're struggling through things as creatives. And yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. Nothing sexy. It is what it is. So I'm going to say it again, seek professional help, and hopefully you can get through it. Hopefully we can all get through it. And hopefully one day this won't be as faux pas of talking about the things that we're struggling with as creatives as it is today. Hope you guys have a great day. Thanks so much for watching. Take care.